Good morning, guys. Welcome to day 49 of our 66-day challenge. Today's word is called war cry. This is a war. And we're going to be reading from Ephesians 6:10 through 18. And let us get into the word. Before we get into the word, let's say a prayer. Father God, I thank you for touching the person that is listening to this. Help them to know that they are dealing with demonic spirits in play, Father God. It may not be the person, Father God, that they feel is with the real war, or it may not be with the situation that they feel is the real war. The real war is spiritual. This is a spiritual battle going on. I'm thanking you, God, for giving them the tools and the resources and the discernment and the wisdom, the insight, the knowledge that they need to fight their battles, to fight this war. I thank you that you're teaching them how to engage in this battle, how to engage in this warfare, whether it be through prayer, whether it be through worship, whether it be through fasting, whether it be through praise, God. In the name of Jesus, whatever strategies you're giving them, God, I thank you that they are going to leave off this broadcast differently, and that they're going to be able to effectively engage in this battle and not view it from a natural standpoint, but more of a spiritual standpoint, God, and knowing that they also have the victory in Jesus' name. Amen. So we're talking about the war cry. So we're coming from Ephesians 6, talking about the whole armor of God. Verses 10 through 18, I'm just going to read it into your ear gate. So it says, a final word, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on all of God's armor so that you will be able to stand firm against all strategies of the devil. For we are not fighting against flesh and blood enemies, but against evil rulers and authorities of the unseen world, against mighty powers in this dark world, and against evil spirits in the heavenly places. So this is not a natural battle, this is more of a spiritual battle. Right? So 13 says, therefore, put on every piece of God's armor so you will be able to resist the enemy in the time of evil. Then after the battle, you will still be standing firm. Someone declare that today, that you are still standing firm in Jesus' name. Amen. So it says, stand your ground, putting on the belt of truth and the body armor of God's righteousness. For shoes, put on the peace that comes from the good news so that you will be fully prepared. In addition to all of these, hold up the shield of faith to stop the fiery arrows of the devil. Put on salvation as your helmet and take the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times and on every occasion. Stay alert and be persistent in your prayers for all believers everywhere. So God is calling us, you know, he's letting us know that this is not a natural battle. You're not fighting against your husband. You're not fighting against your wife. You're not fighting against your children. You're not fighting against your friend. You're not fighting against your sister. You're not fighting against your family. You're not fighting against that co-worker on the job. You're not fighting with that usher in the church. You're not fighting with that person at the bank. You're not fighting at that person where you frequent to go Chick-fil-A, Taco Bell, Red Lobster, any steakhouse, wherever you go. You're not fighting. You're not dealing with them. You're dealing with the spirit that's trying to operate through them. So God is telling you, so with that being said, you know, what you're dealing with, something in the spiritual is not natural, put on the armor of God. So what is he telling us to do? He's telling us to put on the armor so that we can resist the enemy and still be standing in the battle. He's telling us to put on the belt of truth. He's telling us to put on God's righteousness. He's telling us to put on peace. He's telling us to put on faith, put on our salvation, which is our helmet, the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, and continue to pray. So you have those things, you're armed for battle, and it's important to put on all of them. It's important to pray in the Spirit at all times. That doesn't mean you're praying for 24 hours a day. It just means when he quickens your spirit, you're in prayer, you're praying. If you're walking around, you're at work, wherever you are, you're praying, you're in prayer mode. You're praying on the inside, you're praying. It doesn't have to be a 24-hour prayer, but it's a prayer that's released in faith to God. Okay, you having your faith. Your faith is a spiritual tactic. Your faith is spiritual engagement. Okay, you have one peace. You have peace. The enemy wants you to be crazy and losing your mind and being in a loony bin. And you have one peace that drives him crazy because he's not understanding that he's giving it his best shot and it's not working. Because you have supernatural peace on the inside of you and you have God blessing you with these things. You're going to make it. So what else do you have? So you have the truth. You're not believing a lie. You're not being deceived. You have the truth on you. You have God's righteousness. You're not the righteousness of your own. It's not according to your own works. It's according to Jesus and what he did on the cross. So you have all these things and all the other things that I mentioned when we were reading this together. You have your salvation, right? You're saved. You have the word of God. When you speak the word of God, that is a spiritual weapon. that you are using against the enemy, because you are giving God's word back to him and you are releasing that word into the atmosphere, and that is causing damage in the enemy's camp. So when you get some time in your private time, I do encourage you to read Ephesians 6:10-18. This has been a blessing to me over these last 8 or 9 years or so. When I really need to come back to this, God leads me back to it and I read it, and it encourages me. It reminds me of what I need to put on, and that I'm not dealing with people. I'm dealing with spirits, because sometimes the enemy, when he can't get you one way, of course he'll try other ways. And he may try to even work through friends or family or those that's close to you or those that you didn't expect. But that's why it's just so important to have on the whole armor and to really understand that it's not that person all the time. Some people are just negative. You don't need to be around them anyway. But it could be the spirit that's being allowed to use them. So be encouraged with that. Know that this is a war. Release your war cry to God. If that's through worship, if that's through praise, if that's through declaring the word of God, if that's through keeping your peace, if that's remembering your salvation and walking out your salvation, your journey with God, if that's through, speaking the truth, whatever it is that we mentioned, stay in that and know that that war cry is not going to be in vain, and that God is going to help you fight, and that you're going to come out on the other side victorious in the name of Jesus. So guys, I want you to be prepared and I want you to be blessed. I love you guys. I will see y'all back on here later on. Bye-bye. Have a great day.